On the left, you will see the newly released Qwen Image 2512. And on the right, I have generated image using the Qwen Image model released 5 months ago. It's not bad, but I am used to Z Image now. I think the girl on the left has skin way too perfect. If there is anything else I am asked to pick, then it will be her hair. I feel like it's not real. On the right, the word Qwen written on the t-shirt looks edited or AI generated, but on the left, it looks real. I am running the Qwen Image 2512 FP8 model on my 4060 Ti 16GB. Both the models, new and old, are 20GB in size, and comfyUI has managed using system RAM. The text handling capability of the new model is very impressive. The text on the glass looks correct word to word. The image generated on the right using the older model has some mistakes, though. My next prompt is about a wedding invitation card on a wooden desk. Not made of thin paper, but a bit heavy material with text written on it. Below is the text to be written on the card. The image generated by the older model has a mistake. After years of flirting, and few other words have bad letters. I don't think I will be able to get this corrected if I try again, because there are multiple letters which need to be fixed. And this looks okay. The text printed looks correct. This closing bracket looks uninvited. I will change the seed ID and run the workflow again. The way this is working is the nodes with the older model are on the right, and the new model is on the left. The resolution, which is the empty latent image, with the help of reroute node, goes both the sides. And the prompt, which is in this node, also goes in both the text encoder. After 58 seconds, I got the result, and the closing bracket is gone. The result looks correct to me. The difference in both the models are clearly noticeable. Qwen team set about enhanced human realism in the newer model. The prompt is given above. Let's check the realism by loading the FP8 model. This node group with the older model takes 5 seconds for one step, and I am using a lightning LoRa to get the image generated within 4 steps. Similarly, the models used in the left is the new Qwen Image 2512 and the lightning LoRa for the respective model. The iteration time and total time for the image generation are identical to the older model. Let's look at the result. The prompt I am using will be given in the node below. The image on the left is acceptable and close to realistic. I would have been happier to see this before the Z image model. The result looks okay to me. I see some lines and patterns here. Not sure if something is wrong. So basically, this model is not beating out the Z image, but it has been updated, and all the features are enhanced by a few percent. The text rendering capability has improved a lot. I don't know what this Chinese text is about. I will try and find out. I understand this. The prompt is about the improvement of this model in comparison to the older model, and the enhanced realism is clearly visible here. The model is handling a complex prompt to generate such an image. The Flux.2 model should also be able to do this, but the model is quite heavy. I made a video to speed up the Flux model and bring the generation time under 100 seconds. I will add the video link in the description. The model works with long prompts, and it should also work with short prompts. My prompt is about a dragon hovering above a sparkling waterfall under the sky full of stars. I got one image which looks fine to me. The image from the newer model definitely enhances the details of the mystical dragon. It should be the text encoder, or the model, or maybe both. What happens is the prompt I have given here contains words mystical and dragon, and when the text encoder starts processing these words, it brings some words in relation to mystical and dragon. Everything then goes to process. A futuristic sports car, neon lights, reflection on wet streets, Night Racer text in metallic chrome style on the hood. There is something wrong, or I am not able to digest this image. I tried a couple of times, but for some reason this model does not like my prompt. A portrait of a Chinese woman wearing a qipao dress with flower pattern. The enhancement done by Qwen team for lighting is clearly visible in this image. The women with freckles are also improved now. No more fake freckles with this new model. Glowing forest, silver robe with arcane symbols, white hair, pointed ears, a staff emitting blue light, fireflies with ancient ruins. Both the models tried and almost gave what I asked for. The older model, instead of fireflies, gave glowing butterflies. The arcane symbol was missed by the newer model. But I got what I asked for. The ancient ruins, pointed ears, long hair, blue light emitting from the magical staff. This enhancement in the 2512 model in front of us is clear. Let's look at the model files quickly. This section here, you can ignore. I tried a few things with the model. So this is what I was trying, and the older control net did not work. I will stop the case sampler here to stop the image generation from the old model. And this is the workflow you need to look at. Link to the model is on the left. These two models are the latest release. The BF16 model has a size of 40 GB. I'm using the FP8 version of the same model, which generates results within 60 seconds when using the Lightning LoRa. This is the older FP8 model, which I am comparing with a newer FP8 model. Save the file in the Diffusion Model folder. Next is the text encoder. I'm using the FP8 file. Save it inside the text encoder folder. The third file is the VAE, and save it inside the VAE folder. After downloading and placing the files in the correct folder, these are the three nodes where you need to select the download files. And if you are on a system with 12 or 8 gigabyte graphic memory, then instead of these two files, you should get the GGUF files. If your system has a 32 gigabyte of RAM, then try getting a file which is 2 to 3 gigabytes larger than your GPU memory. It should work if you have a 3000 series GPU or newer. For older GPUs, I suggest matching the VRAM because the GPU might be slow. Place these file inside the models and then the UNET folder. This is the GGUF text encoder. Get a file smaller than the VRAM, save it in the text encoder folder, and then you should be good to go with the same VAE I showed here. These are the GGUF nodes where you will select the GGUF files you downloaded and then connect both the nodes. Then it should work. Here, I am using a Lightning LoRa, which is an accelerator in the image generation process. Get any of these LoRa, but the FP32 is better. See if it works and if generation time is acceptable, or else get the smaller file. Place the LoRa in the LoRa folder and select the file here. There is another option for the LoRa. This Turbo LoRa also works as an accelerator. New files are being added here. I have not used any of these yet. The next file is the VAE. I have added here by mistake. It is the same as the above, but this is a direct download link. Below is the upscale model, and this model is used on the right. The control net workflow I showed you kind of worked, but it was like hit or miss, so I can't recommend using it. Let's look at the upscaling section. The connection from the model's text encoder with a prompt and the VA goes to the upscale section to increase the image resolution of the generated image. This node here is for the image-to-image generation. You need to connect this VAE encoder node to the latent image connection and then decrease the denoise value, which controls the changes in the image. Keeping the value at 1 will produce the same image you uploaded. I have made a detailed video on image-to-image generation. I will link the video in the description. Below is a latent image node with different sizes. Remembering 1024 pixels was easy, but Qwen Image has been trained on 1328 pixel image, so these are the recommended resolutions. Connect any one from these and it goes to both the workflow. These nodes are not necessary, but there are some prompts here I was trying to use with ControlNet. Let's connect and run the workflow. The image looks fine, but this should look better in a different aspect ratio. The generation time is consistent, around 60 seconds, unless I add some more LoRa in the workflow. This is the result, and it looks okay. I changed the seed and tried again, and this is the best we can get. Using a 4-step LoRa does not mean it has to be generated with 4 steps. I will increase the steps for a better quality image and run the workflow. The result is noticeably better than the 4-step result. Now I will activate these nodes to have this image upscaled. The seed ID is fixed, which means the image given from here will be the same, and the process will directly start in the upscale node section. This is the upscale node I showed on the left. When upscaling, one step takes 28 seconds, and above is the time taken for image generation. It took 220 seconds to upscale the image at this resolution on my 4060 Ti 16GB card, and the result was good. Now I will upscale again using this Sage Attention node. The image generation started from below because I activated the Sage Attention node. Let's wait. Do note that Sage Attention has no effect in the text-to-image generation process. The image has been generated and now the upscale is in process. Previously, the upscale took 28 seconds for one step, and now with Sage Attention, it takes 20 seconds. So the difference is high if you are working with multiple images. The VAE encode will take time due to the large number of pixels. The upscale process has been completed. Previously, it took 221 seconds, and now it is 178 seconds. The railway track crossing is from the original image, but the upscale result looks way better. So that was the new Qwen 2512 model. The workflow will be given as it is, so you can relate and continue using it. I hope the video was useful, and you all have an excellent day.